This video presentation will provide an overview of operating the 3920 tone encode-decode option. To get the most out of this video, we recommend viewing these videos beforehand. The tone encoding and decoding tiles are accessed from the tile drop-down menu. Each of these tiles can be placed in any position on the display. The tone encode-decode option tiles are also found in the P25, DMR, NXDN, DPMR, and Arab STD T98 systems. We'll first take a look at the tone decoding functions. The first thing to consider is if the input signal is transmitted over the RF link or if the input is a baseband audio signal. If the signal is to be transmitted over the RF link, select DMOD as the input. The instrument can receive the signal directly from a transmitter through the TR connector. The signal can be decoded off the air through the antenna connector. Selecting audio as the input allows the instrument to decode baseband signals applied to the audio input connectors. In the analog duplex system, the tone decoding tile can be configured to decode DTMF, two-tone sequential, tone sequential, and tone remote signals. In the analog duplex system, DMOD DCS is decoded on the analyzer's tile. In the digital systems that support the encode-decode option, DCS is decoded on the tone decoding tile. The tone encoding tile is used to generate the encoded signal. The signal can either be transmitted as modulation on the RF link or as baseband audio. When ModGen is selected, the signal is transmitted as modulation on the RF output signal. The TR connector can be used to connect the signal directly to a transceiver. If the device under test is capable of transmitting high power signals and the GEN connector is selected as the instrument output, do not directly connect the GEN output to the transceiver. Instead, use an antenna. When audio GEN is selected as the output, the instrument generates the encoded signal as baseband audio. The function GEN DMOD out connector is used to output the audio signal. When the output is set to audio, the output port button is displayed on the tone encoding tile. This button is identical to the output port button found on the expanded generators tile. It is placed here so the audio output can be conveniently set to function generator for audio tone encoding. The tone parameter field selection will vary depending on the type of encoding selected. The level field sets the output level of the tone encoding. When the mode is set to audio GEN, the output level is expressed in volts. When audio tone encoding is generated, the generator uses audio generator 1 to produce the signal. While the tone encoding is generated, the frequency, level, and waveform settings of audio generator 1 are overridden by the settings in the tone encoding tile. When modgen is selected, the output is set to FM modulation, and the level field sets the amount of deviation in hertz. When modulated tone encoding is generated, the generator uses modulation generator 1 to produce the signal. While the tone encoding is generated, the frequency, level, and waveform settings of modulation generator 1 are overridden by the settings of the tone encoding tile. To demonstrate modulation generator encoding, we'll connect the gen connector to the antenna connector. This will allow us to generate a tone encoded signal using the tone encoding tile and receive the signal so we can decode it using the tone decoding tile. The gen connector is selected as the generator output. We'll set the RF level to -47 dBm and turn the RF generator on using the RF gen soft key. The antenna connector is selected as the receiver input. The receiver is set to demodulate FM. The receiver is also set to the same frequency as the generator, so it can decode the signal coming from the generator. The tone encoding is set to two-tone sequential, so we need to set the tone decoding to decode two-tone sequential. Now we'll select the tone encoding tile to access the start soft key to generate the program sequence. The instrument has successfully encoded and decoded a two-tone sequential burst. In this example, a tone sequential code has been encoded and decoded. The detailed results for the entire code string can be viewed by maximizing the tone decoding tile. The up and down arrow soft keys are used to scroll through accumulated decode data. The clear soft key will erase the data from the display. In all systems that support encode-decode, the modulator or audio waveform button is used to select DTMF and DCS encoding. We'll now set up the instrument to encode and decode baseband audio signals. To demonstrate audio generator encoding, we'll connect the function gen DMOD out connector to the audio N1 connector. This will allow us to generate a tone encoded signal using the tone encoding tile and receive the signal so we can decode it using the tone decoding tile.